In 2001, Mariah Carey signed a deal with Virgin Records for over $100 million. But the pressure of starring in and recording the soundtrack for the film Glitter pushed Mariah into an emotional and physical breakdown. And when both the film and album flopped, Virgin dropped the singer, leading industry insiders to believe Mariah Carey's career was over.
The failure of Glitter could have ended her career. She was doing crazy things, and her stuff wasn't selling. I mean, that's a lethal combination. But I think she handled that the best way she could, you know, which is, you know, you kind of take a little time off, you straighten yourself out, and then you figure out what you want to do next.
Mariah's time off would be short, however. Just 4 months after being sacked by Virgin, Island Def Jam signed the free agent to a new deal. Mariah's first record for her new label, 2003's Charm Bracelet, stayed in the top 20 for only 3 weeks. It was yet another blow to the superstar's faltering career. Mariah's personal life was faring no better. Shortly after reconciling with her father, Alfred, he was diagnosed with inoperable cancer.
It was very strange because I had just started to understand different elements of my father that I never understood as a kid, and started to have deeper conversations with him and really started to ask him questions. It was really nice to be able to put everything out on the table and just talk.
Although he had a difficult time showing it, he was very, very proud of Mimi. And when he got sick, we learned some things that surprised us, like that he had almost all of her press clippings and her music. I think it was really touching to her.
He was amazing through the whole thing. He really was fighting hard. It was a very tough thing. I guess you just have to keep moving forward and celebrate the person's life.
Mariah took a break from recording, but professionally, the timing was less than ideal. Just 4 years after leaving Sony, Mariah Carey had gone from one of the hottest acts in music to what many were starting to view as a has-been.
She had fallen from that great place, and she was being questioned as she came out swinging. And she made the greatest album and the biggest song in her career.
After being counted out by nearly everyone, Mariah came back stronger than ever with 2005's The Emancipation of Mimi. Powered by her first number one hit in 6 years, We Belong Together, Mimi would become the biggest selling album of 2005, with over 40 million copies sold worldwide. We Belong Together would go on to be named Billboard's Song of the Decade.
Who looked more strong and amazing and like announcing herself as like, you thought what, I was dead in the water? What, you were worried about me? You're embarrassed for me? Because I'm all on MTV handing out popsicles? You thought I had a problem? No, I'm fine. I'm straight, I got this, don't worry about it.
But Mariah's winning streak didn't end there. A new chapter in her personal life began when she attended Fox's Teen Choice Awards and met actor-comedian Nick Cannon.
Every time somebody would ask me about my celebrity crush or who I would love to marry one day, I would always say Mariah Carey. People would be like, yeah, right. Ain't no way in hell you gonna be able to marry Mariah Carey. But I kept saying it like every interview, and said it so much that she heard how fond of her that I was.
On the Teen Choice Awards, they were giving me an award. He gave me the award, and then he just stared at me. He didn't really talk. And I said, thank you for all the nice things you've been saying about me, because every friend I have would be like, man, that dude Nick Cannon really likes you.
I mean it. The truth. Give me a chance. And then the entourage just whooshed her off.
Then we got together again in, you know, a couple years later, and we got a chance to talk, and we connected on a lot of levels.
The pair began dating in the spring of 2008 when Mariah hired Nick to star in the video for her song, Bye Bye. They were married a mere 6 weeks later in a sunset ceremony at Carey's estate in the Bahamas. That same year, Mariah's single, Touch My Body, became her 18th number one hit, leaving her second to only the Beatles. In 2009, Mariah decided to take another shot at acting, playing a tired social worker in Precious.
Mariah Carey was amazing in Precious. And it's not just that she sort of uglied up for the role, and anybody can do that, but she brought honesty to the character.
Within all that glamour, within all that glitter, Mariah found a tired social worker and made us believe it. And I realized as an actress, she had come into her own.
In October of 2010, Mariah and husband Nick Cannon announced that they were expecting a child due in the spring of 2011.
Mariah would be a fabulous mother. She's so nurturing. She cares so much about other people. She'll put other people way before she'll put herself sometimes, and that's a quality that everyone doesn't have.
Over 20 years into her career, Mariah Carey has survived a business that manufactures and discards stars with regularity. But through the painful ups and downs, Mariah fought her way back time and again, ultimately cementing her legacy as one of the entertainment industry's biggest and most enduring names.
Mariah Carey has shown a lot more resilience than I think anybody thought she had at the beginning.
With all due respect to, you know, the other one-named divas, if you will, Celine, Christina, I think Mariah will be the one that defines my generation, without a doubt.
She is the greatest. There is no singer in contemporary music that compares to Mariah. She simply has more talent than everyone else.
You know, she's somebody who's determined to do it on her own terms and to stay around until, you know, she decides that she doesn't want to do it anymore.